Another one. What if the given naman po is a decimal number at ang hinahanap naman natin is a fraction? Example, 0.2. So, ang una niyong gagawin, identify the place value of the decimal number given. So, ano ba yung decimal number natin dyan? Diba po yung 2? All the numbers after ng decimal point, those are decimal numbers. So, meron tayo ditong 2. What is the place value of it? Kapag meron tayong decimal point, remember, this is the tenths place, hundredths place, and thousandths place. Again, tenths, hundredths, thousandths. Every time na may ilalagay tayo or makukuha tayo from the hundredths place, automatic po, for fraction, ang denominator niyan is 10. Kapag naman nasa hundredths place, ang denominator is 100. At kapag naman nasa hundredths or thousandths place, I mean, ang ilalagay natin is 1,000. So, going back here, balikan natin yung ating fraction. Ang sabi ko kanina, hanapin natin or i-identify natin kung ano yung place value ng given decimal number. So, meron tayo ditong 2. So, what is the place value of 2? Okay, the place value of it is 10. And sabi ko kanina, tenths, I mean. So, sabi ko kanina, kapag nasa tenths place, ang gagawin natin, ang denominator niyan in fraction is 10. Now, what will be our numerator? So, automatic, all the numbers after the decimal point will be part of the numerator. So, ilalagay natin dito is 2. Another one. Ang given naman natin is 0.7. Okay. So, again, ang gagawin natin, let us identify the place value of the decimal or the number after the decimal point. Or given numbers after the decimal point. So, ang place value nito is tenths. Again, kapag tenths po, automatic ang denominator niyan is 10. Now, what will be the numerator? Ano yung digit after ng decimal point? We have here 7. So, it means ang numerator niyan ay 7. Next, what if we have not just one digit after the decimal point? Example, 0.25. Okay, so let us change this into a fraction. Lagyan na agad natin ng bar line. Again, the first thing that you need to do is to identify the place value of the digits after the decimal point. Paano po kung dalawa? Kapag dalawa, ang pinaka-titingnan po natin or i-identify natin place value ay yung nasa pinaka-dulo. Okay? So, as you can see, sa 0.25, ang nasa dulo is 5. So, ang gagawin natin, underline natin tong 5. What is the place value of 5? If you're going to identify the place value, this is tens and this is hundredths. So, again, 5 is in the hundredths place. And sabi ko kanina, kapag hundredths place, automatic ang denominator natin is 100. Now, what will be the numerator? Lahat ng number or digit after the decimal point will be part of the numerator. So, we have 25 over 100. Next. Example, the given is 0.03. Okay, so in this part, identify muna ulit natin what is the place value of the digits after the decimal point. And kapag more than 1 po iyan, ang tingnan natin ay nasa dulo. What is the place value of this? Okay, hundredths place. So, the denominator would be 100. Next, what will be our numerator? Sabi ko kanina, lahat ng kasunod ng decimal point will be part of the numerator. But, you don't have to write 0 before 3 because that is already a whole number. So, hindi natin nalagyan ng 0 sa unahan. We don't need to have, or we don't need to put a 0 before 3. Instead, we may write it as 3 because 0, 3, and 3 in whole number is the same.